Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, Lesson Number 22. The topic it is Internal Land Forming Processes. I'm your tutor, Lucine Muthoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today. By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to analyze and also to understand the measurement of the earthquake. We start by looking at the measurement, what is used to measure the earthquake. The instrument that is used for measuring earthquakes is called the seismograph or the seismometer. We can refer to it as the seismograph or a seismometer. There are different types of the waves, seismic waves. We have them, and these seismic waves, they are the ones that are recorded by the seismograph. So these waves are primary seismic waves, which we refer to them as the P waves. Then we have the secondary waves, which we refer to them as the S waves. And we have the long waves, which we refer to them as L waves. Let us look at their characteristics. When we talk about the primary seismic waves, they travel faster. So that is the reason as to why they will reach the seismograph faster, of being the first one. They cause rock in their path to compress and expand in the same direction the waves are traveling. So that is about the seismic waves. Then we look at the secondary waves. Vibration or their movement reaches the seismograph later after the P waves. So it is the second one to reach the seismograph. Then we look at the long waves. When we talk about the long waves or the L waves, they have long amplitude wiggles. They are broad waves. They have the broad waves. That is the seismograph. That is the instrument that is used to measure the earthquake. As you can be able to see how it is moving. This is the instrument where we have the seismic wave reaching, getting to. So you can be able to see how the waves are moving from the seismograph. From the diagram, you can be able to identify the primary waves and the S waves. So, you can see that the P waves reached the seismograph faster or before the S waves. So, you can see the second, the time they took. For example, when we talk about the P waves there, it is taking 5 minutes. But when I look at this, the S wave, the first one reached there after 30 minutes. So you can be able to see time difference. Then, activity. Explain 4 effects of the earthquake. Number 2, state 2 instruments that are used to measure the earthquake. Then, for more information, you can refer from from the KFB. These are the waves that we have already mentioned, we have taught. The earthquake, the magnitude, and the measurement.